I'm sure you'd agree that the very best electrical jobs are the ones where you start with a completely blank canvas, you can really make it your own, you've not got to worry about tying into existing systems. However, we also know that that isn't always the way that it works. So I've popped back down to Devon to meet up with Theo Webster Electrical Services, winner of not one but two eFIXX awards. They got Commercial and Industrial Install of the Year as sponsored by Delego, and also winner of a 30 under 30 award as supported by BG Luceco. And we're going to have a chat about the challenges of combining the old with the new on this job and how that's leading them on to the exciting new work that's taking place elsewhere on this site. So Theo, I've been outside talking about new work. This doesn't look like a brand new building to me. It looks like it might have been here some time. So tell me a little bit about what's going on with this job.
Yeah, so it's phase one of a two-part job for us. Yeah. So this used to be a vehicle workshop. It will now become servicing bays for motorhomes.
Yeah.
So we came in with the client and basically the wiring was very old. I'm not sure exactly how old it was in here, to be honest. But we priced to completely rewire it, using as much of the existing containment that we could.
Right.
Installing new where necessary. And so we've, chucked in completely new wiring. We were going to try and save some parts of the wiring, but once we started working on further inspection, it wasn't salvageable.
Yeah, you find that, don't you, on existing jobs? You sort of get to that point where it just comes a point where you've got to cut your losses and you think there's no point trying to salvage that now because it'll be quicker actually just to take care
Absolutely, definitely. Yeah, it's definitely quicker sometimes just to renew than it is to work with what you've got.
So we've got lovely, nice new trunking behind us here. That looks really nicely installed with your excellent conduit bends. I'm going to look at those in a bit more detail in a minute.
Yeah.
but what sort of challenges of connecting the old to the new? I mean, obviously, was the existing trunking in just pristine order when you needed to extend it?
No, it was pretty beaten up.
Yeah, pretty bad.
You know, as you would expect from any sort of workshop of this age. Yeah. So, you know, we've had to adapt certain parts of it, replace, just so that we can actually, so it's usable.
So we've come over to the distribution board, Theo. I noticed we've got a Kit Kat chunky there, so we're approaching tea break. We'll wait till we're off camera to eat that. But it's looking like this is a very, very full distribution board. We've got a lot of circuits in here, and this doesn't feel like a huge space. So tell me about what's going on inside here.
Yeah, so there's a lot going on for the size of the unit. The intentions are it's going to be three servicing bays for the motorhomes.
Okay.
So each bay's got a 32 amp and a 16 amp single phase supply.
Okay.
As well as a three phase supply for future vehicle ramps.
Brilliant.
There's a ring main in each bay as well, consisting of six twin sockets, just for angle grinders and things, whatever they may need.
Yeah.
We've got 32 amp and 16 amp supplies around the rest of the workshop as well, all single phase, just for charging leisure batteries on the motorhomes and things like that. So we've tried to make it as versatile as possible. So no matter what they need it for, where they need it, they can charge vehicles or whatever, wherever they need it.
It's a really good approach to design that, isn't it? Just making sure that you've got everything exactly where you need it, everything's fully equipped, and that there's an element of future-proofing.
Definitely try to future-proof it, I think. It was a difficult install. With the way the wiring goes up and over the roller door, it was a really difficult pull to get cabling in. So we tried to do it as much in one go so that I haven't got to come back and try and do it again.
There's nothing worse than trying to pull cables past existing cables.
Yeah,
and get
definitely.
Burning and everything.
Yeah,
it's a nightmare. No, I understand that. And just looking at some of the finer details inside here as well, we've got, it's nice to see we've got A-type RCDs, not ACs.
Yes.
So that's good. So is that just for this installation, or is that something you're doing?
No, it's something we do as a standard, really. Yeah. To be honest, I think it's the way the industry's going.
Yeah.
It's all going to go that way. So.
Yeah. I mean, in reality, there's so little you can actually get away with using a Type AC.
Exactly.
These days,
makes
sense. Yeah. And surge protection again, standard or
as standard
calculations?
No, I personally don't see the point. I know there's a lot of contractors that will offer it to clients as a cost difference, particularly in domestic. I just think it's completely pointless.
Yeah.
I think for what the cost of it is,
in like
a domestic consumer unit.
Yeah.
I think you may as better off just fitting it.
Yeah, versus the cost of the homeowner replacing it.
Absolutely. Yeah, definitely. Yeah. So, SPD is standard. Yeah.
That's good. And one thing I really like, of course, as part of the eFIXX Awards, we had the marketing category, which, of course, you weren't successful in that one.
No.
But what is nice to see, everything's branded here. So we've got the Theo Webster Electrical Services on the front. And I particularly like that we've got the required stickers. Yep, they were also branded. But then this little one down here, I mean, that looks like it's been made to measure for this Hager distribution board.
Yeah, it's not for it. It's not designed for it. It's come off of a single U data cabinet blanking module. I just trimmed it down, stuck it in there.
Well, it looks absolutely brilliant.
Branding is key.
Branding is key, absolutely. And that's actually a really nice finishing touch on that distribution board. I like it. So we've moved the van inside now, Theo, because we've got that beautiful paint job that we're showing off. It's just been freshly wrapped and it looks absolutely fantastic. But it looks fantastic partly because of the lighting that we're under. So talk to me, what fittings have we got in here?
So these are from Bell Lighting. Yep. So I think they're 100 watts now. I can't remember, it's a while ago since I've done this. I think they're 100 watt fittings. So Bell Lighting are fantastic. They did the design, so they spec the lux levels and all that as well. And they then give you the detailed drawings as well. So really brilliant. It's definitely going to meet the requirements of what my client needs as well. The only thing that might have to be an addition going forward, because of the motorhomes, obviously they're quite tall and wide. Yeah. We may have to look at local lighting, but until they start using it, it's something that we just don't know.
Yeah, and also I guess when they're up in the air as well, you probably need some kind of localised hand lighting anyway to have a look under there.
Yeah.
Makes perfect sense. But it's good that it's all been designed because, again, you know, light levels, especially in an area where work activity is taking place, it's not something you want to take a gamble on and just go, well, this is what I'd put in here. You want it doing properly.
From your main light and also your emergency light as well, you know, you don't want to be responsible and then suddenly it's not right.
Couldn't agree more with that. Now, Theo, I've spotted a problem with your business model, because this job is completely finished or very nearly finished and you've got an awful lot of product left over here, I can't help but notice. So why is there so much stock left over from this job?
This is for phase two. So we've got the new building coming up next door relatively soon. I approached my client in, I think, April when we actually priced it. And I said, look, you know, prices are going up.
Yeah.
By the time it comes to October, we're actually going to start wiring. You know, you're going to potentially look at another 15% increase on materials, which we've definitely seen on some manufacturers, if not more, particularly with cable.
Yeah.
So, you know, we agreed that he would purchase all the gear at the time to avoid any increases in costs, and I think that will work massively in his favour.
I think that is such a good idea as well, because it solves that problem of increased costs over time, as you say, that nasty surprise of, well, we quoted this much, but now it's this much more. And also, it means that you've not got the delays of stuff getting on site.
Absolutely, some of the manufacturers are giving us 3-month lead times on items. We've got a lot of Hager gear. Mm-hmm. Not all manufacturers... Wholesaler, we'll be able to supply all that in one go.
Yeah.
You know, I had to wait a while to get some of it in. So, you know, particularly with the boards, they're all SPD boards. They're not just standard off the shelf. We've avoided any sort of lead time errors and things like that. So.
Yeah, it's a really good idea. It means you've got your stock on site. You've not got that increased cost problem. And also, not behind the eight ball, are you, with your stock coming in, which is fantastic. So all of this is ready for a few weeks now.
Yeah.
When that job starts, we can get that moved in.
Yeah, that and the job will be quite fluid anyway, because, you know, we'll be on site and varying parts of the building will be ready at different times. So this way we can just crack on with whatever we need to do as well.
Excellent. Great idea. I've really enjoyed my time on site with Theo today, mainly because it's shown that he really is a worthy winner of an eFIXX 30 Under 30 award. He's showing just the right blend of ambition, but also tempered by contentment to mean that he's built a business that shows a really reasonable, manageable level of risk in what it carries out. So I really hope that things continue to go well for Theo. It's been really nice getting to know him. And if you think that you're a worthy winner of an eFIXX award, then keep your eyes peeled for when we open nominations later in the year. If you've enjoyed this video, please check out these ones here, and thank you very much for watching.